Hello friends, here we have a problem in which we would be calculating the total pressure and center of pressure acting on one side of a vertical tank. Let's read the question here. A tank contains water up to a height of 0.5 meter above the base, an immiscible liquid of specific gravity 0.8 is filled on top of water up to 1 meter height. Calculate total pressure on one side of tank. Next, position of center of pressure for one side of tank which is 2 meter wide. Now, this is the question which they have given. Whatever is given here, we will write that in the form of data first. So, let us get started. Here the question is to calculate total pressure. Total pressure is nothing but hydrostatic force acting on one side of the tank, and the second part is position of center of pressure for one side of the tank. That position of center of pressure is h star, and the width of the tank is given as 2 meter, so b is equal to 2 meter. Next, an immiscible liquid of specific gravity 0.8 is on top of water, so specific gravity is equal to 0.8. So density will be equal to 0.8 into 1000. So the density of the liquid is 800 kg per meter cube. Now, this is the question which we have. I'll draw the diagram in the solution part. In the solution part, here I'll draw the tank. Now I'll read the question again. A tank contains water up to a height of 0.5 meter above the base. So there is water filled up to a height of 0.5 meter from the base. Next, an immiscible liquid of specific gravity 0.8 is filled on top of water up to 1 meter height. So above water we have another liquid which is immiscible, means it will float at 1 meter height. This immiscible liquid is there. Now this would be exposed to atmosphere. Here I am writing that symbol. Now, as we can see in this diagram, here we have two different kinds of fluid. One is water and the other is oil. Since it is floating, specific gravity is given, density we have calculated in the data. Now, such kind of problems, they can be solved by using the concept of pressure diagram. Now, what is pressure diagram? Let us see here. I'll project the lines here. Since oil is there, now what will happen is that as we go deep into the level of oil, pressure will go on increasing, because we know from hydrostatic law, pressure is directly proportional to the height inside the fluid. So once we go deep into water, the pressure intensity will go on increasing. Next, this pressure intensity of oil will be constant for water. That is, the pressure exerted by the oil on water is constant. Next, there is even water up to 0.5 meter. So because of that also, there would be, as we go deep into water, there would be an increase of pressure. So now, this is the pressure diagram. Here, the horizontal values will give me pressure intensity, and vertical values are nothing but height. So this is the pressure variation, or I can say this is pressure variation diagram. the pressure variation diagram. Now I'll name this. This is A, B, C, D, E and F. First I'll calculate how much pressure is exerted by oil. So for that purpose, I'll write down, since pressure intensity because of oil, I'll call it as P1, that will be equal to rho g into height, a simple formula. This is from hydrostatic law. Now therefore P1 will be equal to, rho is the density of oil, it is 800, g is 9.81, h is the height of the oil column, which is 1. So from this I will get the answer of P1, it is 7848 newton per meter square. Similarly, I'll calculate the pressure exerted by water of 0.5 meter height. Now, pressure intensity because of water, it will be P2 is equal to rho gh again. So therefore, if I put the values here, rho is 1000 for water, we know this value, g is 9.81, height of water is 0.5. So from this I'll get my answer of P2, and that is 4905 newton per meter square. Now once I know these two pressure values, I can show it onto the pressure diagram. The pressure exerted by oil, this is 7848. I'll just write the number, unit we already know. Next, pressure exerted by water, that is 4905. These heights are also known, 0.5 meter and 1 meter respectively, for water and oil. Now, from with the help of this pressure intensity diagram, now we would be calculating the hydrostatic force. See, the concept is different here. We are calculating the hydrostatic force at the bottom of the tank, and for that we have used this pressure diagram. I'll say that since total hydrostatic force is given by, I'll write down F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3. Since we have two triangles here, two right angle triangles and one rectangle, so total hydrostatic force is given by F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3. I'll call this as my first equation. Now I'll calculate these values separately. So I'll say that therefore F1. Now F1 is the hydrostatic force which is exerted by triangle ABC. So I'll write the area of this triangle. It will be half into base into height, and your base is BC, into height is AB. So I'll put, and I'll multiply it by the width of the tank, because that will give me the total hydrostatic force. So it is area into width. Now I'll put the values here, half into BC, that base is equal to 7848, we have already calculated, into AB, AB is 1 meter, we know that, into width of the tank is given as 2 meter. So from this, if I calculate, my answer comes out to be F1 would be same, here 2 and 2 gets cancelled, that is 7848 Newton. Now once I know F1, I'll write down F2. F2 is the rectangle, that is hydrostatic force for rectangle BCED. Here it is 7848 into 0.5. It is very simple. 0.5 is the height, so base into height, that is 7848 into the height, which is 0.5, multiplied by again width of tank, that is 2. So from this I'll get F2 answer. My value is, I have calculated previously, that comes out to be, again it is 7848 Newton. So even F2 is same as F1. Now I'll calculate F3. So F3, it will be equal to F3, as we see in the diagram, again it is a triangle, so half into base into height, base is 4905, so half into 4905 into height is 0.5, multiplied by the width of tank, which is 2. So from this I'll get F3 as 2452.5 Newton. Now once we know F1, F2, F3, we can put all values in equation 1 to get the answer of total hydrostatic force. So I'll say that, therefore, put all values in equation number 1. So here we have F is equal to F1, 7848 plus F2, that is also 7848 plus F3, 2452.5. So if I calculate, if I add all these values, my answer is, it is 18,148.5 Newton. Answer number one. Now, after the calculation of hydrostatic force, next we will calculate the center of pressure. I'll write down, since center of pressure, it can be calculated by, I'll take the moments of all hydrostatic forces at point A. For that, what I will do here, just pay attention here. As we know, this is a triangle ABC, so its hydrostatic force would be acting at, this will be F1, acting at 1/3 of 1. So it is 1 by 3rd meter. Next, the hydrostatic force for that rectangle, it would be acting at half of its height. Height is 0.5, so half of 0.5, that is 0.25 meter. Next, the third triangle, for this again the hydrostatic force would be at 1/3 distance, this is F3, so it is 1/3 from the base, or we can say it is 2/3 from the height. So 2/3 of 0.5. See, it is very simple here. Now after getting these hydrostatic forces location, I'll take the moment of all forces at point A. So I'll say that, therefore, taking moments of all forces about point A, so here I have F1 into, since it is 1/3 from the base and from point A, this distance would be 2/3, 2/3 of 1, that is 2 by 3 meter. So I want this distance, I am taking the moment. So F1 into 2/3, next plus F2 would be acting here at point A. AB is 1 meter, so 1 plus 0.25, that is 1.25. So plus F2 into 1.25 plus for F3 it would be equal to 1 plus 2/3 of 0.5. So plus F3 into 1 plus 2/3 of 0.5. Now these moments should be equal to the moment of total hydrostatic force, that is F into, and that location is called as H star. So now I'll go on putting the values. F1, it was 7848 into 2 by 3 plus F2, again 7848 into 1.25 plus F3, it was 2452.5 into 1 plus 2/3 of 0.5. That is equal to hydrostatic force total F, that is 18148.5 into H star. From this, if I calculate the left hand side value and divide that by this right hand side value, my H star comes out to be, it is 1.009 meter from point A. My second answer. So as we see in this problem, they were telling us to calculate two things, that is hydrostatic force and its location, that is the center of pressure. Total pressure was the question and position of center of pressure. So total pressure, we have found out the value is 18,148.5 newton, and center of pressure H star, we have calculated it is 1.009 meter. So now with hydrostatic force and center of pressure calculation, we can say that the problem is completed.